Dear friends, welcome back. In this video, we built yet another temperature monitor using Arduino. But this project is different. It can last on batteries for almost 1.5 years. Yes, that's correct. The battery life of the project is over 1 year on 3 rechargeable AA batteries. Let's see how to build it and how we can achieve such a long battery life. Let's do it. In this project, we use a DS18B20 temperature sensor in order to measure temperature, a Nokia 5110 LCD display in order to display the temperature, a photoresistor in order to detect night and disable the LCD display to conserve power, and of course, an 18MB 328 microcontroller with Arduino Uno bootloader. The power consumption is reduced to minimal by putting Arduino on sleep when it is not measuring the temperature and by disabling the LCD display at night. Also, the Nokia 5110 LCD display is ideal because with the backlight off, it needs only around 0.2 milliamps of current. Arduino spends more than 99% of its time sleeping and only wakes up for a few milliseconds every 2 minutes. That's why we can achieve such a long battery life. Let's now measure the actual current draw and calculate the battery life of this project. As you can see, when Arduino is sleeping, it only needs around 0.26 milliamps of current. As you saw, Arduino woke up for a few milliseconds and went back to sleep. The current draw went up to 11 to 12 milliamps and now it's back to 0.28 milliamps. If I cover the LDR in order to emulate night, the LCD goes off, and as you can see, Arduino is sleeping and the power consumption, the current draw right now, is 0.07 milliamps. In order to quickly calculate the battery life of the project, I have prepared an Excel file. As you can see, we enter the data from the multimeter here, we can then change the parameters in green, and we have the battery life in days calculated in this cell here. So, if we use a battery pack with a capacity of 2500 mAh, like the one I use, if we measure the temperature every 2 minutes, and if the display is off at night for around 8 hours, we can achieve a battery life of 518 days. Impressive, isn't it? We can change the parameters and see how they affect the battery life. If, for example, we measure the temperature every minute instead of every 2 minutes, we have 11 days less battery life. So, with this tool, we can easily make the project to fit our needs about power consumption and interval of measurements. Of course, these calculations are only theoretical. In practice, the battery life of the project will be less because batteries discharge even when they are not used. The Enelu Pro batteries that I use claim that they only lose 25% of their power after 1 year of no use. Cheaper batteries have, of course, worse self-discharge rate, so the use of good batteries is crucial in order to achieve long battery life to your project. Now, let's see how to connect all the parts together in order to build this project. The parts needed for this project are these: an 18MB 328 chip with Arduino Uno bootloader, 2 22 picofarad capacitors, a 16 MHz crystal, a DS18B20 sensor module, a photoresistor, a 10K resistor, and of course a Nokia 5110 LCD display. The cost of the project is very low, less than 10 euros. 3 euros for the 80 mega chip, 2.5 euros for the Nokia 5110 LCD display, around 2 euros for the DS18B20 temperature module, and a few cents for the other parts. Let's now see how to connect all these parts together. First, we built our own Arduino. Please check our detailed tutorial on how to build your own Arduino Uno on a breadboard. Then we connect the temperature sensor. Minus goes to ground, plus goes to VCC, and output goes to digital pin 7 on our Arduino. Then we connect the photoresistor. We connect this leg to the ground. The other one via the resistor goes to digital pin 6 because this is the pin that is going to power on LDR only at specific times. And we connect the other pin to analog pin 0 in order to measure light. Then we connect the Nokia 5110 LCD display and we are ready to go. Let's try it. As you can see, although that I have powered on Arduino via this power bank, the LCD display is off and it seems that it's not working. What's going on? Look what happens if we remove the capacitors from the breadboard. The circuit works fine. But why is this happening? Breadboard pins have their own capacitance. They act as small capacitors themselves. So we add more total capacitance to the crystal, so it does not work correctly. The breadboard pin's capacitance depend on breadboard, I think, so try your own circuit with or without the 22 picofarad capacitors to see what works for your project. Now, in order to see how to program the 80Mega328 chip, check our previous tutorials, but I have found another easy way to program the chip. Let's see. If you have a standard Arduino board, you can remove the 80Mega chip from here and use it to your pairboard Arduino project. So you can use your Arduino Uno as a programming environment for your bare Arduino project. For example, we can enter our 80Mega chip here, plug it into our computer and program it with our software. Then we can easily remove it and add it to our breadboard. It's that easy. Be careful, the reset pin goes this way down. In the breadboard, we put it the other way. So it is so easy. The code of the project is simple and easy to understand. We are using the low power library, the DS18B20 library and of course the Nokia 5110 LCD display library. Please check our previous videos in order to see more details about how to use those libraries. If you need your project to display degrees Fahrenheit instead of degrees Celsius, change this C here into NF. At first, we initialize the sensor and the display. Then, in the loop, we first power on the LDR. In order to further decrease the power consumption of the project, we don't provide power to the LDR all the time, only when we want to measure light, every 2 minutes for 10 milliseconds. So we read the value from the LDR, if there is enough light we measure temperature, we display it on the screen and we go to sleep for 2 minutes. Else, if it is night, we disable the LCD display and we go immediately to sleep without measuring the temperature. That's the code of the project. Please post any comments or questions about it in the comment section below. That's today's project. We finally achieved to make an Arduino project that can run on batteries for over a year. Now we can move on to more advanced projects that can run on batteries for a long period of time. The weather station project will be the first one to benefit, so stay tuned. Please feel free to post any questions or ideas to the comment section below. Press the like button if you like the project and subscribe to our channel in order to watch our future videos. Thank you very much and see you next week.